Hello friends, this video is about the process of taking backup for the course. So this can be done regularly or must be done at the end of the course. So let us say I have this course, basic electronics, and I am done with my all the course related evaluations and content sharing and all. So there are some quizzes, there are lecture slides which are shared, there are assignments, all these things, and some of these we may need for the next year, or we just need it for our backup, all the question banks that we have created. So to perform the backup, we go to the gear icon and go to backup. Remember, when we take the backup, we will not get the marks and user data. That means who are enrolled in my course and how much they scored in every exam. That thing, as an instructor, we cannot take the backup. So when we click on the backup, it will show you that what are the things that you want to take as a backup, and you can see that enrolled user data we cannot take. You can directly jump to the final step if you have been taking backup for Moodle earlier, but you can just go to next, and now you can select every individual thing that you want to include in your backup or exclude. I am excluding lecture slide because that will make my file little bulky, and here also I am excluding the lecture slide. I am taking the practice sheet, I am taking the quizzes. Remember, only the quiz will be taken as a backup, but how the students have performed and their marks, that will not be taken. All the mid-sem and sem, everything. And then I go to next, and it will go give you the preview that these are the things we are going to take, these are the things we are going to exclude, all these things, and then you say perform backup. So backup is created, click on continue, and now you just scroll down and you will see how many times have you performed the backup, and all the backup files are available. You can actually restore your course to any available backup. So this is the latest one which I have created. So click on the download. This MBZ file, you can store it at relevant place, and that will keep all the information of your course. Now let me show you how are we going to use this in the next year. So I am in my next year. Here is again my basic electronics course, and it's like a blank. There is nothing here. So I go to restore, and there I choose the file, and I'll upload that same file. So now this file will be uploaded, and I will click on restore. When I click on this restore, it is going to tell me that this was my previous version and this is your current version, whether they can be matched or not, all these things, and these are the things which are included or excluded. These are the things which I am going to take in, and we click continue. Now there are two things. One is restore into this course or restored into another course. I have few more courses, so we'll say no, this in the same course. And then there are two options, whether we want to merge it into the current content or delete the existing course completely and take everything from the backup. So that is all up to you, whichever option you select. We click continue, and then few more things if you want to include from your backup. By default, we just leave it and click on next. These are all the things that are going to be coming in, and if you want to exclude something, you can do that. And then go to next. It is giving you the brief summary, what are we going to do, and perform restore. So that is the simple process, and when you continue, you can see that whatever I have in my previous course, all of them have come here. What is the difference? This is my previous course. If I go to my previous course and I go to quiz 1, I can see there are 571 attempts and how these students have performed. But if I go here to quiz 1, I will not see that how many students data is not there, but you can see what was the quiz. So quiz is still available, all the questions are available, the complete question bank is available, but only thing is the user data is not available. Now coming to the user data, which is a very important thing, how do we take backup of that? So now let us say I want to take backup of my quiz 1, mid-sem mark, assignment 1 marks. Go to the particular evaluation component. So let me start it again. Basic electronics, midterm, I want to take the backup that how students had performed. I go to attempts and here it is showing 489 students and these are their question wise marks. Come here and select enrolled user who have or have not attempted the quiz and click on show report so that it will give me the data of complete 600 students, not only 489. I have 600 students in this course. And then you say download as Excel or CSV, whichever you prefer, and you download this. This file, when you save, it will be your basic electronics midterm Windows user grades. This will give you the marks for every student question wise, because sometime we may need question wise marks. So these are the names and there were, I think, 9 questions. Yes, 9 questions, and question wise marks are there. Why this is important? Because for every evaluation components, you are getting question wise mark. There is another way, which is called going to the grades. When you go to the grades and you say I want to export the grades in an Excel file and you select the components which you want to include and you download them, it will again give you an Excel file, but the difference is this Excel file will not give you question wise marks. It will only give you quiz 1 this much, quiz 2 this much, quiz 3 this much. So it will be more like for our final data compilation. But if we need question wise marks, please go to the individual components. Now if I want the question wise marks for maybe quiz 1 or practice quiz 2, anything, go there, go to the attempts and select enrolled user who have or have not, and then click on show report. Once it shows the report, then download the Excel file. So please do it for all the courses that you have taught in this semester. Thank you.